The Inter-Religious Council of Uganda was addressing the media on the events that have transpired in the country for the last 1 week. These condemned the violence and hooliganism, which led to loss of lives and the barbaric arrest and torture of different individuals, including the members of parliament. The president may address the nation on a particular subject depending on what he has been told. For example, yesterday, when he addressed the country on Honorable Zakhe's situation, he said that the police is looking for him yet the legislature is in hospital. This is not the first time because even last year, he was misinformed on our statement on the Toji Kwatako issue.
We have made every effort after every incident to go to the sites and assess for ourselves and get to know the truth. It is out of that truth that we can be able to address the nation conclusively.
The Inter-Religious Council has also called upon government to respect the constitutional rights of every player in the country.
Therefore, call upon the government whose major obligation is to protect the people and their property to do the following. One, to ensure that members of parliament, their supporters and other persons arrested during the Arua electioneering are treated with dignity in accordance with their rights and that they access justice through open courts of law.
Meanwhile, the much-anticipated national dialogue organized by the Inter-Religious Council is underway and is expected to be held in October with an aim of finding lasting solutions to the problems facing the country. Similarly, Ugandans have been urged to desist from acts of hooliganism and use of provocative and inflammatory statements during electoral campaigns.